Damen und Herren, recht herzlich willkommen auf dem Flughafen von Berlin-Tegel. Wir möchten Sie bitten, gemeinsam mit uns noch so lange angeschnallt sitzen zu bleiben, bis wir unsere endgültige Bahnposition erreicht haben und die Anschaltzeichen über Ihnen nicht mehr leuchten. Öffnen Sie dafür die oberen Ablagen vorsichtig, damit eventuell verrutschtes Handgepäck nicht herausfällt. Und überzeugen Sie sich vor Verlassen des Flugzeuges, dass Sie auch nichts Persönliches bei uns an Bord vergessen haben. Im Namen der Air Berlin, Oneworld und unserem Partner Etihad Airways wünschen wir Ihnen jetzt einen guten und sicheren Nachhauseweg, den Besuchern einen erfolgreichen Aufenthalt oder eine angenehme Weiterreise. Vielen Dank, dass Sie heute unsere Gäste waren. Bis zum nächsten Flug. Alles Gute. Tschüss und auf Wiedersehen. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Volunteer Airport. Please remain seated if your seatbelts fastened and to reach off on the parking position at the fastened seatbelt signs have been switched off. Be careful when opening the overhead luggage to prevent hand luggage falling out. Air Berlin, Oneworld, as well as partner Etihad Airways, wish you a nice and pleasant stay here. Thank you for flying in Berlin. We hope to see you soon. Take care. Goodbye.
Online.
Since 1997, when we first introduced the Bib Gourmand, it has been incredibly popular, which is why we decided it was time for the Bib Gourmand to have its own guide. Bib Gourmands, as you can see, have had tremendous growth since 1997, over 50% growth. It shows that people want to go out, they want to go to restaurants, but they're also looking for good value. And the Bib Gourmand hits that spot perfectly. The German edition of the Guide Michelin is a pillar in the Guide Michelin's footprint around the world. As you know, the Michelin Guide was started first in France, but then expanded to Europe shortly thereafter, and we continue to develop our activity around the world. In 2015, we have 24 guides in 25 countries. We also have, 25 guides in 24 countries. We have two new additions to the Michelin Guide family this year. We have a Rio, Sao Paulo, Brazil edition, which was launched in April of this year. And we also have a guide to the Nordic countries, reflecting the creativity that's going on in both Brazil and the Nordic countries. We have with us today something I would like to also, recall to you just the, some of the key issues that are surrounding this year's guide in Germany. It is the 50th year of the introduction of the Michelin star in Germany. It was in 1966 when the first Michelin star was awarded in Germany. There were 66 one-star restaurants. That was a great start. And 50 years later, you will see when we reveal the selection just how far gastronomy in Germany has come. I would also like to welcome the fact that we have one restaurant and only one restaurant in Germany that has had a Michelin star for 50 consecutive years since 1966. This restaurant has been passed from generation to generation. We now have the third generation of the chef who is here with us today. That restaurant is Adler, and I would like to welcome Florian Zumkeller on stage from Hausung in Südschwarzwald to thank you. Over 3,300 hotels. The Michelin Guide provides addresses for every occasion and every price range. So that's a very important message. Whatever you're looking for and whatever you want to spend, you can find a good choice in the Michelin Guide. The edition will be on sale in bookstores starting on November 13th. This year we have a record of 290 starred establishments in Germany. It's something I think that really reflects the excitement, the creativity, and the innovation that is going on in German gastronomy today. If you look at the evolution over the last few years, you see a 25% increase in the number of starred restaurants in Germany. That is phenomenal, and I think it's a tribute to what, how much is going on here, how this generation of young chefs and not so young chefs are pushing the envelope, continuing to create fantastic new cuisine. What did our inspectors see this year, and what are the trends they saw? And they saw this, as I said, this high creative energy that is percolating throughout Germany. They see this young generation of chefs who are unafraid to express themselves, use different ingredients, different cooking techniques to create purely personal food, which is really what our inspectors are looking for. Many of these restaurants have been awarded stars in 2016. And I'm very happy that we have some of these young chefs with us today because they have earned stars. I would like to, I'd like to welcome a young chef now, Mika Schaefer from Noble Heart in Schmutzig here in Berlin. Please join me on stage.
This is one for the hometown team, so. Thank you very much.
Pleasure, thank you. Welcome to the Star Club. You're a welcome addition. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Luca. Why don't you stay on the stage with us? We've got some of your friends that come up. I'd also like to welcome Gautam Bush from the restaurant Gustav in Frankfurt. Sen's father, if my memory is correct, had two Michelin stars as well. So anyway, I think that's great. That shows that the generations are passing around this tradition. These young men represent these young chefs, these young artists represent, the future of gastronomy in Germany. So thank you all, our congratulations, and we look forward to following you for your next star. So keep up the good work, we need you. Thank you very much. Restaurants in Germany. That is quite an achievement. You're going to have some jealous countries out there wondering how you did it, and it's because of the quality of your ingredients and the quality of your chefs. I think it's a fantastic, fantastic achievement. I'm also proud to say that five of these 26 are hometown boys. They are from here in Berlin, and then Bondos Jobert, Bibabau, Markus Tabler, Richard, and of course, Mika from Nobelhaus and Schmutzig. So it's a great year for German cuisine. It's also a great year for Berlin. And I think that represents the excitement and innovation that's going on in Germany and in this fine city. Let's talk about two-star restaurants. There are four new two-star restaurants in Germany. That's also a record. The two-star is one of Michelin's highest accolades. It represents food that's worth the detour. I think it's really a reflection of the highest achievement in gastronomy, and we're welcome, my pleasure to welcome today, Sebastian Frank from Horvath in Berlin, another hometown boy. Our chef is Andres Kolik from La Fleur in Frankfurt. In München. And I'd also like to welcome oh, sorry. I'd also like to welcome the owner and general manager, Madame Ingrid Voigtat, who's here with us today. Thank you very much for making this journey. It's really a pleasure to have you here with us. And now, a herzlich willkommen von Thomas Schanz from Schanz Restaurant in Peaceport. Represents one of our highest awards, as you know. It's extremely difficult to get two Michelin stars. It's extremely difficult to maintain two Michelin stars. So I want to congratulate you guys. You're really putting the bar very high here in Germany, and I think you're an inspiration to those other chefs who are looking at you around the world. You know, German cuisine now, my travels take me all over the world. I was just in Hong Kong last week, and before that I was in the US, in New York, Chicago, and San Francisco to launch the US guys, and Monday I'll be in Ghent in Belgium. As I do these launches around the world, I can tell you that Germany and the German chefs and German cooking is becoming more and more on the horizon for everybody. People are looking to Germany now for inspiration, looking to Germany to find out what your secret is. How are you able to get all these Michelin stars? And this is the reason why. So thank you very much, gentlemen. Congratulations, and we're going to keep following you. Thank you. And now, while we've seen the one stars, we've seen the two stars. And of course, the next thing we're going to look at is the three-star restaurant, which is the summit of Michelin Guide Awards. It is the highest award in our universe. I am glad to announce that Germany now has maintained 10 Michelin three-star restaurants, which is an enormous feat. It's an incredible achievement, and it is second in Europe, only to France. So I think your friends in France are starting to get nervous as they see Germany coming up behind them in the three-star category. We do have some wonderful news this year. It's very exciting. I want to welcome Kevin Feeing to the stage, please. Kevin, come back to the camera.
As you know,
Kevin had, of course, three stars in the Belle Epoque in Lübeck. Kevin, as many chefs do, decided that he wanted to do his own thing, become a chef owner. He had one of the most exciting openings that we've seen anywhere in the world this year at the table by Kevin Feeling, a new concept of using his food. It is really a remarkable restaurant. And he did the difficult feat of translating three stars from Lübeck to Hamburg and didn't miss a beat. So that is a true achievement. So we were glad to see that, and it's a very exciting place. Thank you very much, Kevin.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. We also have other three-star restaurants. Here they are. I think that it's very important to mention that having a three-star, a third Michelin star, having three Michelin stars, is not a lifetime achievement award. It's something that you have to re-earn every single year. Our inspectors are out there visiting all the restaurants, visiting all the starred restaurants several times a year. We send different inspectors. We send French inspectors, Italian inspectors, Japanese inspectors to Germany. It's very important that a Michelin star around the world is a symbol of quality. Of course, food in Tokyo is different from food in Hamburg, and food in Hamburg is different from food in Madrid. But the Michelin star is a sign of quality, and our readers can be sure that using the Michelin Guide around the world is a symbol of quality that they can count on. I would now like to invite all of the Michelin star chefs here with us to join me on stage so we can have a group photo of everybody. So please, gentlemen, the ones, the twos, and the threes who are with us, please come on stage so we can have a photo.
Im Namen der gesamten Crew wünschen wir Ihnen